A very good morning to all the students. I'm your SST teacher, Miss Dipali Sharma. Students, I hope you all are fine and fit. Now, students, let's start our today's class with the sentence of the day. So, today's sentence of the day is, practice makes a man perfect. I repeat again. Practice makes a man perfect. Now students, let's start our today's class. Students, today we will do the chapter number 1 of Civics, Understanding Diversity. So take out your Civics book, chapter number 1, Understanding Diversity. And today is 22nd July 2020. Now students, before I start with the new topic, let's recapitulate the yesterday's topic. So, now Isha will tell me that we have done which topic yesterday. Right, very good. Yesterday we have discussed about the diversity of Ladakh. And today we will discuss the diversity of Kerala. So, let's recapitulate about Ladakh. So yesterday I have described you about the Ladakh, right? Ladakh is a desert in the mountains in the eastern part of Jammu and Kashmir. As I have explained you that Ladakh does not receive any rainfall and it covers with snow for a large part of the year, right? So the people of Ladakh keep goats and sheep with them. The goats are very special in Ladakh because it produces pashmina wool, right? The people of Ladakh eat meat and milk products like butter and cheese, right? So the people of Ladakh does not receive any rainfall. So for drinking water, they depend on the melting snow during the summer season. Being a desert, a Ladakh did not mean that it does not attract the share of traders. It was considered a good trade route because it had many passes through which the caravans traveled. And caravans carried textile, silk and carpets with them, right? So Islam was introduced in this region when more than 400 years ago, right? So today we will read about the Kerala, right? So our today's topic is Kerala. So a Kerala is a state and it lies in the southwest corner of India, right? It lies in southwest corner of India, right? It is surrounded by sea on the one side and hills on the other side, and a number of spices like pepper, cardamom, cloves are very famous here, and they all are grown on the hills. These spices attract a number of traders here, right? Many Arab traders came here and settled down here. Ibn Battuta, who traveled here a little less than 700 years ago, he wrote a travelogue in which he mentioned about the lives of Muslim and said that they were a highly respected community, right? So because of these historical influences, the people of Kerala practice different religions, right? The people of Kerala practice different religions. Right? Now, Aaron will tell me that the people of Kerala practice different religions. You have to mention those religions. Yes, very good. So, the people of Kerala practice different religions like Hinduism, Buddhism, Islam, Christianity. Right? Now, students, the people of Kerala eat rice, fish, and vegetables. And Onam is the festival which is very famous in Kerala. So the boat race in Onam is very popular. Right? Now, students, I have explained you about the Kerala. Now we will read about the Kerala through the book. Now, students, we will read about Kerala. Page number 10. Kerala is a state in the southwest corner of India. Students, you have to underline this line. Kerala is a state in the southwest corner of India. It is surrounded by sea on one side and hills on the other. A number of spices like pepper, cloves and cardamoms are grown on the hills. So, as I have explained you that Kerala is surrounded by the sea on one side and hills on the other side. And it produces more spices. It is spices that made this region an attractive place for traders. Jewish and Arab traders were the first to come here. The apostle of Christ, Saint Thomas, is believed to have come here nearly 2000 years ago, and he is credited with bringing Christianity to India. Many Arab traders also came and settled down here. Ibn Battuta, who traveled here a little less than 700 years ago, wrote a travelogue in which he describes the lives of Muslims and says that they were highly respected community. So students, as I have explained you that many Arab traders came in Kerala and settled down here. Ibn Battuta, who traveled here a little less than 700 years ago, he wrote a travelogue in which he described the lives of Muslims and said that they were highly respected community. The Portuguese, who discovered the sea route to India from Europe when Vasco da Gama landed with his ship here. You have to underline this line. The Portuguese, who discovered the sea route to India from Europe when Vasco da Gama landed with his ship here. Next, because of all these various historical influences, people in Kerala practice different religions such as Judaism, Islam, Christianity, Hinduism, and Buddhism. The fishing nets used here look exactly like the Chinese fishing nets.
and are called chinwala. So the fishing nets used here look exactly like the Chinese fishing nets and are called chinwala. Even the utensil used for frying is called china chatti, and it is believed that the word chin could have come from China. The fertile land and climate are suited to growing rice, and a majority of people here eat rice, fish and vegetables. As I have explained you that the majority of people in Kerala eat rice, fish and vegetables. Next, while Kerala and Ladakh are quite different in terms of their geographical features, the history of both regions has been similar cultural influences. Both regions were influenced by Chinese and Arab traders. It was the geography of Kerala which allowed for the cultivation of spices, and the special geographical location of Ladakh and its wool that drew traders to these regions. So, if we compare Kerala and Ladakh, they are quite different in terms of their geographical features, but both regions were influenced by Chinese and Arab traders. Thus, history and geography are often tied in the cultural life of a region. The influence of diverse culture is not merely a thing of the past. Our present day lives are all about moving from one place to place for work, and with each move, our cultural traditions and way of life slowly become a part of the new place we are in. Similarly, in our own neighborhoods, we live close to people from several communities. Our daily lives are about the ways in which we do things together and hear stories about each other's lives, customs and traditions.
Now students, we have read about Kerala. So now we have read about the Kerala and Ladakh both. So if we compare Ladakh and Kerala, so they both are different in terms of their geographical influences. But if we compare their region, so they both were influenced by the Arab and Chinese traders, right? But Kerala grows more spices and the people of Ladakh produces more wool, right? So, but their geographical features are different from each other, right? Kerala lies in the southwest corner of India and Ladakh lies in the eastern part of Jammu and Kashmir, right? So, as I have told you that India is a country of many diversities, because we have different languages, we celebrate different festivals, we are having the different cultural backgrounds, and we all eat different kinds of food. So India is a country of many diversities. So present day lives, if you talk about our present day lives, so it's all about moving from one place to another for work, and then we try to adapt the new surroundings, the new traditions and cultures of that region where we have settled down, right? So students, today we have read about the Kerala. Now students, write down your homework. So your homework is, read page number 10 and 11 of chapter 1 civics. Right? So you have to read page number 10 and 11 of chapter 1 civics, that is understanding diversity. Now students, whenever I will give you the written homework, now you don't have to send your homework on the school app. Now we will give you the dates that when you have to submit your homework. So students, you have to attend your classes on a regular basis and you have to complete your homework on a regular basis and positively. Till then, you have to read this chapter. Thank you students. Have a nice day.